Good morning, students. In today's class, we will be discussing about the third module. Right? Today we will start the third module, which is about arrays. Okay. So now, before we start defining what is array and how to use it, what are the features and all, let us start with some simple concept. Say we want to declare an integer and initialize it. How do we write it? Anyone? Tell me how to declare and initialize one integer. How do we declare and initialize an integer? Hiren, how do we declare an integer? Okay, anyone can answer. You are all unmuted itself.
Variable, any variable.
Yes, tell me the statement to declare an integer.
Int.
I hope you are able to see the white screen. Are you all able to see this screen?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, okay. Yeah. Tell me how to declare and initialize one integer.
Int a or any variable.
A equal to 4. Okay. Right. So here, what are we doing in this case? We have declared one integer a as 4. Okay. So now, what is the meaning of this? It means that we have one variable. Okay. So that means, say, let me take. There is one memory space, right, in which we are going to store the variable, right? So this has a name, A. Okay, and inside this, we are going to store the value, right? So 4 is stored in this. And this variable has an address, right? Say it has some address, 50, correct? So this A is a name of the variable. Its value is given as 4. So we have one memory location where we are storing the value as 4 and assume its address is 50. Okay. So in this case, we are going to store just one integer, right? So these are the basics to understand the concept of array. Okay. So here we are storing just one integer in one memory location. So when we say there are many locations, right? So in this case, we may have so many locations, like we may have a set of memory locations. So we may have a lot of locations. I'm just drawing like this. So consider this is a memory location. We have many cells, right? So here we have so many cells. So this is what we have discussed initially. Right, just a part of this memory we consider. Now inside this, say this is for A. Okay, so we are going to store A here. What is A? A is 4, right? So say this is already full, so it has some value, right? So if we have one more integer, say B, if this is free, we will store B. If B is given a value of 5, let us store B here. And then this is full, maybe all these are all full, right? So if these two are, three are full, then C will be stored here. So like this, we have some memory location. So C maybe some 6. If we have some 10 variables, so it is not necessary that all of them may be stored continuously. Okay, so to understand arrays, we need to know first, say we have some 10 related numbers. Consider like there are 60 students in a class and all of their marks need to be stored. Now, if it is stored in many different locations, it becomes difficult to access. So if it is stored continuously, so if we have a memory location like this, here we store first variable, here we store second, okay, and then here we store the third. It becomes easy for us, right, to access. So that is the reason we use the concept of arrays. So what is this array? We have multiple data stored continuously. Okay, so here if we observe, so we can take this example. So 1, 2, 3 and all are stored in continuous memory locations, right? So now we need to first understand continuous memory locations. So the starting address need to be known. So if we have just one variable, we are storing it in one cell. So if based on integer or float, each cell may be 4 bytes, or if it is double 8 bytes and so on. So the memory size depends on the data type. So in this case, it is integer. We have one cell, so 2 or 4 bytes depending on the machine. So if we have one, if we consider 4 bytes, this is just one memory cell storing one integer of 4 bytes. Now if we have to store another, we need one more cell, right? So we need one more cell here continuously. So this may be for B, right? B will be stored continuously. We are storing 5 here. So it will have next address. So like this, we need to store all the variables continuously. So in this case, let us say we have continuously stored some 5 variables. Okay. So we have 5 variables. We have first value 4. Then next we are storing 5. Next we are storing 6. Okay. 7 and 8. Right. So here I'm just considering with some spaces in between. So see how the array is getting stored, right? So these are the numbers. So if we store this, we have the numbers. Each one is in a different cell. So first one is the first value 4. Second cell will have 5. Third cell will have 6. Fourth cell will have 7. And fifth one will have 8. So this is one array. Okay, so here if we observe, they are stored continuously. Now, when we say this, if we have 5 variables, we may give name like A, B, C, D, E, and so on. Now, the concept of arrays, the advantage is we will give a single name here. Okay, so if we have just this one, so this will be called as array A. Right, so just give array name one single name. Now we need to identify each of these numbers, right? So to identify the numbers, there is another number given. So there is something called as index. So what is this index? So there are a few terms we will be discussing, which is very much important to know. A is the name of the array. Index is a particular number given to identify the value of the array. Let us see. So we have the first index always starts from 0. This is very, very important. Index of the array starts from 0. Like we have seen in loop. So the first index will be the first value of the variable. So similarly, the first index always starts from 0. So that is a rule. Second index will be 1. Okay, then it continues. So 2, 3 and 4. Okay, so now when we say this, this is the representation of one array. Now, how do we recognize each array element? Please listen very carefully. So now we have written A here. A is the name of the array. 4, 5, 6, 7 are all values. And then we have on top some numbers. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So these are called as index, right? So first index of an array is always 0. So if we have to say the first value is 4, we are going to denote it in a special way. Please note the way it is recognized. So first we write the name of the array, A. And then within square bracket, we will write the index. What is the first index? It is 0. Close the bracket, then equal to 4. So 4 is recognized by A of 0. If we say of, does not mean we are multiplying. It is A within square bracket 0. So this is how the first number is recognized. Okay, so a of 0 is nothing but 4. When we write a of 0, it means the first value in the array named a. So a is the name of the array. Within square bracket we have index equal to value. So if we write in general, so name, okay, so or if you want to say array, a name, let me say a name is nothing but array name. Within square bracket we will write index, okay, equal to value. So this is the general way of writing any array. Array name, within square bracket, index equal to value. Now please tell me, anyone can answer, how do we recognize third, that is this sixth number, six? How do we write six? We have written 4 as a of 0. What is 6? I repeat my question.
A in the bracket 2.
4 is written as is equal a of to 0. How do we write 6? Yes?
A of 2 is 6.
A of 2. Very good. So 2 a of is equal 2 is to nothing 6. But 6. Right? So this is how we are going to recognize each value. So first number is a of 0. Second number will be a of 1. Third one will be a of 2. Then a of 3, a of 4. Is this representation clear to all of you? Yes? Okay. So let's read the concept again. So here, when we want to store arrays, we will have continuous memory location used. Okay, so continuous memory locations are used to store all the values of the array. So for any array, we are storing multiple values. We are going to give a name. A name for the array is given. It may not always be A. It may be any name based on our example. Based on our application, we may give. We want to store all the price list, or we want to store the items we have purchased, or we want to store books, or whatever we want. So that particular application we can consider and give the appropriate name. So here, just as an example, I've considered a simple A as the name. So A is the name of the array. So for an array, we'll have multiple values stored continuously. And these are identified using numbers called as index. So this index always starts from 0. Very, very important to note, an array index always starts from 0. Now, if we have to recognize the values, so it is recognized using the array name and index. So in general, we write array name within square bracket, index, and then equal to value. This is how we can recognize each value of the array. So we have the first value is 4. 4 is recognized as A of 0. 0 is the first index. So A of 0 will be the first value. Okay. So similarly, 5 is recognized as A of 1. And 6 is the third value. So it is A of 2. And similarly, we continue. So now, what is the size of this array? So we have the number of elements. So this element has 5 integers. Okay, so array length is 5. Okay, so length of the array is 5 in this example. Okay, so we here we have length is the number of elements in the array. So here length is 5. So don't take the index. So we have to count length. How do we count? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So normally, like how we count, the number of elements is nothing but length of the array. Right. So one more thing, I have a question. Are the values of the same type? Yes or no?
Yes.
Yes. Yes. How do we recognize that? So here, all are, what is the data type?
Integer.
Integers. All are integers. Very important to note. This is another important property of array. It is homogeneous. Homogeneous means all the values are of the same data type. Okay. So it is called as a homogeneous structure. homogeneous structure. That means all the values of the array are of the same data type. So we cannot have one integer, one float like this. Here we cannot write 5.5 and 6 or 7 cannot be replaced as b like this. We cannot have any of this. So 7b or something. So that cannot be written, right? So here we have all the values of the same data type. So we cannot have a combination 4a and then 6.5, then next number 7 and then something else. So we cannot have like this. A combination of different data types cannot be given. So while declaring only, we have to specify what is the data type. So this is not possible. Okay, all different data types cannot be given in one array. For that, we have some other data structure, right? So this cannot be given. So here we have the first part. So in this case, length is 5. How do we declare this array? So if we have just a single integer, we have seen we write int and then name of the variable equal to value, right? So this is initialization and declaration together. Now if we have to declare this array, so the syntax is somewhat similar. We have to give the array data type. That means all the elements are of type int here. So specify int space array name. What is name here? A. Within bracket, we have to specify the length. Remember, it is not the last index. What is the length of this array? It is 5. Right? So that means this is the declaration of an array of 5 elements. So here, we have declared, that means it is going to reserve memory of 5 integers, right, for the array A. So we can then store the values. Is this clear till here? So is the basic concept clear?
Yes.
Yes,
ma'am.
So let us continue further. Now we have seen that we have an example with an array name A. It is a homogeneous structure. All elements in the array are of the same data type. So in this example, we have taken integer. All the elements are of type integer. So we declared one array. So this is just a declaration. It does not have any of these values. So it is just reserving 5 memory cells for this array. Continuous memory cells are reserved. And we have to store only integers in all those 5 memory locations. So this is what we understand. So this statement is just a declaration, right? Declaration of array. So once we declare, we need to initialize. We need to give value. So how can we declare? If we have to initialize first number, so we have to give like A of 0. Equal to, give the first number 4, right? When we give this, it is like writing A equal to 4. A equal to 4, if we write, it will store 4 in the memory of variable A. Similarly, if we write A of 0 equal to 4, this 4 will be stored in the memory A of 0. That means array A and first index is 0. So 4 gets stored here. Now if we have to store next number, similarly we have to write here, right? A of 1 equal to 5. Then similarly write A of 2 equal to 6. And this we have to continue. If there are 100 numbers, we have to write it like this. So in this case, if it is the same operation, you can recognize here, identify that all of them are similar operation. When we are repeating multiple operations, what type of statement can be used? If we are repeating set of instructions, use. Anyone can answer. We are repeating set of instructions. How do we repeat multiple times? What is the logic used to repeat a set of instructions?
Loop.
Very good. We have seen different types of loops. right? We can use any type of loop. We have seen examples. John, loop. So we have seen while loop, for loop, and do while loop. Correct? So we have seen loops in the previous module, module 2, previous classes. We see that we can use while loop, for loop, do while loop, etc. So let us say we will consider a for loop. Now we see that A is there, common, and then brackets. When we see these, indexes are getting incremented. Okay? And then we need to give values here. So we can accept a number, right? So this we need to take. So first we can say this 0. So let us say we take for loop. For, now let us say we take a variable index I. You can take any. I starts from 0. This is important. Always index starts from 0. Now we need to continue. So 0, 1, 2, 3 up to 4. Right? Index will stop at 4. So this 4 is less than 5, right? So I will be less than 5. Why is this given? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 are the indexes, which is I. All of these are less than 5. And when we observe, we see 0 plus 1 is 1, 1 plus 1. Each time it is incremented by 1. So we may write I equal to I plus 1, or simply write I plus plus. Right? So here, we have written this. So in this case, we may continue for this further. So we have just a statement. So here we need to initialize A of 0. So bracket. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. All these values are got by the array, right? For loop index. So that is nothing but 0, 1, 2 are all values of I. Right? So we can write in general for this A of 0, A of 1, A of 2, we can write it as I, right? A of I is the value. Now we need to take input. What is the command to accept input?
Scanf.
Scanf, okay. So here we have the command is scanf, right? So all of these are integers. So we need, the syntax remains exactly the same. We have one integer. We will take one only at a time. So 4 and 5, one by one, we will take input. So just one integer. So percentage D and A of I. So this is the syntax to take the input. Right? So this syntax is used to take the input for these variables. Right? So similarly, if we want to print, we may print in the same case. Right? So here we want to print. Okay? So for, we can use the similar format. For within bracket. So index always starts from 0, then a semicolon. I, here we have given length as 5. Depending on that, we will give the condition. So I less than 5, semicolon, I plus plus. So this is the index. We want to print these values. So printf, we will print the values. So what are these values we can give? So say we want to print first element. So A, right? Or if we just give array, right? Percentage D. So here we are just giving one number, percentage D, right? Array element. So now for this, the first array element has to be printed. So A of I, right? So this is the printf statement. Okay, it got a little. So we have the statement here. Let me write it here. For, I'm writing this again. right? A equal to 0, I equal to 0, I less than 5, I plus plus, right? So here we have printf. So we need to print the elements. Let me give just percentage D. Okay, we need to give A of I. So here, let us see how does this work. So in this case, we have the first value. First, we need to take input. So we will go to printf later. Say we need to take input first to print it, right? So first we have the input statement, I is equal to 0. So it will accept one number, okay? And then I value is 0. So instead of just giving A or B, X, Y, Z, we have given A of 0. Okay, I value is 0. So it will take input. If we enter 4, it will get stored into A of 0. So that 4 what we enter is the first value. It gets stored here. Okay, in A of 0. Next, I becomes 1. We need to take input for A of 1. So whatever next number we enter will get stored into A of 1. Say we enter 5, it gets stored next to 4. Okay, in A of 1, next memory location will be 5. Similarly, next I becomes 2. So A of 2 is the next input. So whatever number, say we enter 6, it gets stored to A of 2. Okay, so A of 2 will be 6. Then I increments again. So 3. 3 is again less than 5. So next number will be A of 3. So if we enter 7, 7 gets stored to A of 3. Next number, again I is incremented, I becomes 4. 4 less than 5, condition is true. So next number will be A of 4. So if we enter 8, it gets stored into A of 4. When we increment I further, I becomes 5. 5 less than 5, condition is false. It will stop taking input. Okay, so it has taken input for 5 numbers. So and then stored them continuously in the array called as A. So this is input. Okay. Similarly, now output will be to print this. So if we want to print the first number, okay, so this loop is used to print all the elements of the array. So it starts from 0. Index always starts from 0 for an array. So I is equal to 0. We want to print some number. So here we are giving A of I. If you want, you can give a slash T, slash N and all in between. So in this printf, so not a problem. So I've just given the number. Okay. So if we give A of I value is 0 in the beginning. So it will print A of 0 value. What is A of 0? It is 4. Right. Yes. It is 4. So here in this case, 0 is taken first. A of 0 is printed. Next, I becomes 2. 1. Then A of 1 is printed. So that is the second number. So that it prints 5. Next, I becomes 2, then third number, A of 2, that is 6 is printed. Next, I increments to 3. Okay, 3 less than 5, A of 3. A of 3 is 7. So it prints 7. Again, I increments, it becomes 4. 4 less than 5, condition is true. It should print A of 4. So it will print A of 4, which is 8. So all these 5 numbers are printed. Next, if we give the condition increment, again, I becomes 5. 5 less than 5, condition is false. Control comes out of the loop. Okay. I hope this is clear. Right. So we have one doubt based on the condition. So here the doubt says, what if we give I less than equal to 5? So then what happens? It starts from 0. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. And then we will get another number 5. If we give I less than equal to 5. Right. If we give I less than equal to 5, so that depends. If we start, so I always starts from 0 only. So in this, I is equal to 0 only. So when we count this, we will get 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and then we will get a number 5. So size will increase and that cannot be stored. We have declared A as only 5. Okay, so we cannot give one more number extra. You will get an error. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 will make it 6 numbers. 6 is larger than 5. So if you have only, say, 4 boxes, you cannot keep 5 elements, right? 5 items in that. So that's the problem, right? There is no space. So we have declared only 5 elements. So we cannot store 6 numbers. So only till A of 4 only. You cannot declare I less than equal to 5, because array always starts from 0. If you give like this, it will give error. I hope this is clear now. So based on the size, okay. Yeah, so based on the size, we have to give the condition. So here, always array index starts from 0. Because we have declared A of 5, we will give I less than 5. If you want to give more numbers, you can declare an array A of 10. Okay, then you can give A starts from 0 less than 10. So for that case, you have to declare array int, say some number, say B of 10, if we declare. So for this, we have declared array B of size 10. We can store 10 numbers. In A, we have declared only 5. So we can store only 5 numbers. So that size has to be given during declaration. Okay. So there are different cases for this also. We will discuss them one by one. So fundamentally, we will discuss the first type, which is this, where we are declaring with the length. Let us see different types as we go on with the example. Okay. So I hope this is clear. Okay. So in this case, we can give, if we declare 10, we can give I less than 10. Right. Any doubts? Is this concept clear? Is this
yes,
clear?
Ma'am.
Yes. Okay. So let us see. Let us continue with this. So first problem in this is simple input and output. What is the meaning of that? We are taking input of array elements and then we will print them. Okay. So that we have just now discussed. Taking input for array elements, we will take using a for loop and scanf. Then we will print them. Okay. So for loop and printf. So this we will combine and write it in one program. So that is the very first program. Okay. So I will be sharing this lab sheet also. Lab sheet 3 is for module 3. Okay. So basically in module 3, we are starting with arrays. We have different types of arrays. One dimensional array, two dimensional array, and different concepts based on array. And then we will have strings. Okay. So module 3 is all about arrays and strings. So one by one, we will start. So today we just started with the definition and the basic concept of array. So this is nothing but one dimensional array. It has just one row. Okay. So further two dimensional, when we discuss, we will see further what, how it can be done. Okay. So this, what we saw now is nothing but one dimensional array. Okay. So let us see. How did we discuss this? So here we saw this, right? The different concepts based on array. So how did we declare an array? We have seen. So that is the data type and then name of the array within bracket, the length. So this will declare int A of 5. That means it declares an integer array named A of length 5. Okay. Next, we saw the representation and the terms. Index always starts from 0. And then array name has to be given. It has different values. So the length of this array is 5, right? So index starts from 0. Then next we saw how to represent them. A of 0 is nothing but 4. Then second number is A of 1. A of 1 equal to 5. A of 2 equal to 6 and so on. We can continue. So this length is 5. So we have 5 numbers in this array. So to take input, we can use the for loop. Or any other loop can also be used. So here I've just considered for I equal to 0 because the first index is always 0 for an array. So when we see the index, it starts from 0, ends at 4. Okay. So that 4, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 are all less than 5. So condition is I less than 5. And we observe every time index is incremented by 1. So I plus plus has to be given. So first value is 0. We need to take input for A of 0. So we are taking input using scanf. Since it is declared as integer, give percentage %d. We may declare array of type float, char, or any other data type also. So depending on that, we will give corresponding format specifier. So here we have declared int, right? So here percentage %d, comma, like we take input for any variable, we give and variable name. Here it is the array, right? A of I. So first value is 0, so A of 0 and then A of 1, so on, we take input up to A of 4. Next part we discussed is how to print them. So like we print normal numbers, we print the array also. So A of 0, it will be the first number, so that is printed. I value starts from 0, so we take A of 0 and that is printed. Then similarly, A of 1, 2, 3 and 4. When I becomes 5, condition is false. So these are the commands, like a code for taking input for an array and then printing the values of an array. So let us see the first program, right? So this is lab sheet 3. We have based on one dimensional array. So let us first read the program question, right? What is this problem statement? So if we see this, I've just shared the lab sheet. Okay. So lab sheet problem 1. So this starting is what we discussed, that is one dimensional array. Also it is 1D array. 1D array is nothing but one dimensional array. So what is the problem statement? Mr. Ashish wants to buy 10 items from the shop. He wants to store the price of all the items. Help Mr. Ashish to store the price of all 10 items. So he has purchased 10 items and its price needs to be stored. Now it is better if everything is stored continuously. Then it can be used later to find the bill, add them or whatever we want to do. Right? So then he can keep track of his expense and all that. So based on that, we have one problem, right? So now we need to store 10 elements. So 10 items price. So that means we need an array of size 10. So initially we have the requirements also given. So second part of the question is the requirements, wherein we see that declare an array of size 10. Because we need to store the price of 10 items, we have to have an array of size 10. So declare it. So let us say we declare an integer array. So int A of 10. So that will be a statement similar. Then read the price of all 10 items. So how do we read? Using scanf. Then display the price of all 10 items. So very much similar to problems we have done before. We saw how to work on a character. So take input for a character, display. So that is the very first concept to introduce this concept of array. So the first problem is just simple input of array and output of array, right? So we have one dimensional array. We will take input for 10 elements and then print them. So you just enter 10 numbers and then that will be printed. That is the problem statement. I hope the problem statement is clear now. So let us see. So like always, we are going to declare, use the standard header file. Okay. Int main or void main, whatever we need, we can give. So now we need to take, declare an array, right? We need one index also. So we have seen that we need an index A of I, right? Or you want J, X, Y, Z, whatever you can take, right? So I is just an index variable. So then we have declared an array here. Note that the name of the array is taken as item, right? That is based on our application. In this, we want to store the item price. So we have taken item. You can take any name, right? And what is the size? We need to declare an array of size 10. So we are mentioning the size is 10. So this statement is to declare an array only. We have not taken any input as of now. We have just declared an array of size 10. It will reserve 10 memory spaces for the array named item. Okay, array name is item. 10 continuous memory locations are reserved now for this array named item. Next, we have to store the values. So here, just one printf statement is given for the user. Enter the price of 10 items. Okay, then we have the array like we just discussed. So this part, can see I is equal to 0. Array index always starts from 0, and because we have 10 is the size, right? I less than 10, I plus plus. So scanf percentage d, all are integers, so percentage d, and name of the array is item of I. So it starts from item of 0 and then 1 and so on up to item of 9. So 0 to 9, it will take 10 numbers as input. Okay, so now 10 numbers are considered. We have taken 10 inputs, right? 10 numbers. Next, we need to print them. So price of 10 items are just print using the for loop. So for the index starts from 0, I less than 10, I plus plus. So we are printing something here. Please observe, there are two percentage D symbols. So first percentage D corresponds to I. Okay, just the index. what is the first value of I? Harsh Kumar? Zero. Right? First value is zero. It will print item of zero equal to. Then second one is the value. Say we enter first prize as 50 rupees. So it will print item of zero equal to 50. Okay? So that is the way it executes, right? So let us see. So in this case, So here we have the program which takes input. So first part is taking input. Second part is to print the elements. So in this case, if we just give the same thing, right? So let us say we have, I'll just create. What is the command to create directory? Mkdir. Let me create, right? Mkdir array. I've just created. Now enter into that array. Peter always, yes, to create different directories so that it is all organized. So I'll just create for the first program. So then notepad, say array input. Any name, just give just a name. So here we have the notepad. Let us, right, the next new screen is shared here to you all. So you can see that screen. We will just type the program. So first part, hash include. Right. So here we have the header file, hash include stdio.h. Next, void main or int main, both are fine. So we will just, first what is to be done? We need to declare. So let us take int and take I. Okay. Then we see items are to be stored. Let us take the value item and then we need to give the size. So this declares an array of size 10. Right. Now we need to give a input. Right. It has to accept the input. So just give a statement. Enter. I'm just giving 10. Right? Any statements can be given? 10 items price. So just 10 numbers need to be taken as input. So now we know that we have to take continuously A of 0, A of 1, A of 2. So we will use a for loop. So for index I starts from 0, okay, and I less than size is 10. We need 10 elements and I plus plus. So we are using, you may use a bracket, okay, or it's also optional because we just have one statement, right? So if required, you use bracket, or else without bracket also it is fine. Because if it is only one statement, brackets are optional. So if you feel you get confused, you can leave that bracket. So since it is all integers, percentage, comma, and A of I, right? So this part will just take input for 10 numbers, right? Now we also need to print them, right? So next we will printf. You can give array elements, whatever statement. Sorry. Array elements are, just give a slash n, right? So now we will print one by one. So what are the array elements? We need to print each array element. Let us use a for loop because there are multiple array elements. For, so I equal to 0, I less than, size of array is 10 here. So each time it increments by 1, so I plus plus. Now, we may give a bracket, or since it is single, we can omit the bracket also. So here, we are printing the element along with the index. Please note, so just a slash n so that each one is printed in a new line. I will give item, this is a name and square bracket and percentage d. So this is the first percentage d equal to percentage d. So this is because we want to print like this. So if we take the example, we have seen a of 0 equal to say some 4 we took, right? So it needs to print this, right? 0 is the index. 4 is the value. So for this, the first one is percentage d is for the index. Index variable is I, comma. Second percentage d also we have to define. Otherwise, it cannot map it, right? So it will give error otherwise. So here, name of the array is item of I will give us the value. How does this work? So item of I is equal to 0. So it will first print 0 and then, so name of the array is item. So it has to print item of 0. If we enter 4, it will print 4 or else whatever we enter. So is this clear? Let us execute this once. Okay. So here, please observe. So I am just saving this. And compile. So compilation in MinGW is GCC. Okay. So here we have given the name of the array in item. And then, okay, sorry. You have class, another. Right, here I have taken just as A only. Right. This is not A. This is item, right? Name of the array is item. Yeah, just a minute. Almost done. So, cleared this. Okay, once it compiles, we will just give input. So, enter 10 items, give 1. One space 2. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, so you can see the array elements A of the item of 0, 1, 2, 3. Right? All of you enter your name and roll number in the chat box. Okay? Yeah, you have class, right? Fine. You can enter your name and roll number through the chat box. I hope this is clear. So we printed item of 0 is the first value. We entered 1. Then second number, item of 1 is entered. Its value is 2. Item of 2. Then I values are printed within the bracket. And whatever we have later is the values. I will be sharing some recorded videos also. Please watch them. Okay, I will share the links in the group. So that concepts will be clear. And I am going to share lab sheet as well. Please execute this program and try those. There are solutions also. Okay. So because your timetable is a little altered, tomorrow you will not have CP class. I will share recorded video. So next CP class will be on Saturday. Okay. Until then, I will be sharing recorded videos. And also tomorrow 8 p.m. you have your quiz. I've mentioned that in the group. Okay. Yeah. So thank you very much.